Alright, hello everybody, and today we're going to be having a look at one of the integral representations for the Dirichlet eta function. And if you've seen my previous video on the integral representation of the Riemann zeta function, you'll notice that this integral right here looks very familiar because all I've really done is I've changed this negative right here into a positive. And that's kind of one of the differences between the eta function and the zeta function in terms of its integral representations. It's just a little bit different. But we're pretty much going to be using the exact same method to evaluate this thing right here. So let's actually just get started. Just like last time, we're going to multiply top and bottom by e to the minus x. So we're going to have e to the minus x times x to the s minus 1. Over, and then e to the minus x multiplied into this denominator right here, we're going to get 1 plus e to the minus x, okay? And we want to turn this denominator into a geometric series somehow. And for a geometric series, we need 1 over 1 minus something. But we have a plus right here, so we can turn this plus into a double negative. So we can subtract off the additive inverse of e to the minus x. And you can check for yourself that negative e to the minus x is always between 0 and 1 on this interval for x right here. And since that condition can be met, our geometric series will actually converge. So we can rewrite this a little bit. So now we have the integral from 0 to infinity, e to the minus x, x to the s minus 1. Then our geometric series, so k going from 0 to infinity, we're going to have this term right here. So negative e to the minus x, but raised to the kth power, and dx like so. Okay, now we can distribute this exponent right here into this product here of negative 1 and e to the minus x. So I'll actually do that on this line right here, just to save some space. So we're going to have negative 1 to the k, and then e to the minus x times k like so, and dx. Okay, so now we can pull this sum to the outside because we know this sum converges, so interchanging limits won't be a problem there. So we're gonna have the sum running from k equals 0 to infinity of, and I'm gonna bring this negative 1 to the k out to the front as well, so negative 1 to the k. Then I'm gonna have our integral from 0 to infinity. I'm gonna write this term first, so x to the s minus 1. And then we're going to have e. We're going to combine these two exponential terms together. And you see we have this negative x that's common on the exponent. So let's factor that out. So we're going to have x. And then we're going to have k plus 1 on the inside of these brackets right here. And now, just like last time, this thing right here looks almost like a gamma function. So let's introduce a new substitution. Maybe that can help us out a little bit. So we're going to let our new variable t be equal to this part right here, x times k plus 1s. And if we differentiate both sides, we can have dt, derivative of x times some constant is just that constant itself, so k plus 1 times dx, which means that dx is equal to 1 over k plus 1 times dt. And we can rearrange this equation for x as well, so x is equal to 1 over k plus 1 times dt like so. Okay, and now substituting all this stuff back into here, we're going to get the sum running from k equals 0 to infinity, negative 1 to the k, integral, and our bounds will still be preserved because if you plug 0 into this x right here, our t will be 0. If you plug infinity into this x, our t will still be infinity, so our bounds are preserved right here. And then x to the s minus 1. Remember, x is this thing right here. This should be a t. So we're going to have t to the s minus 1 over k plus 1 to the s minus 1 power. And then we're going to have e, and then this part right here, we said that was t, so we're going to have e to the minus t. Dx is 1 over k plus 1 times dt. And notice we already have a k plus 1 right here, so if we multiply another 1 into here, we're just going to add 1 to this exponent right here, so we're just going to have k plus 1 to the s. And then we have our dt, like so. Alright, so this part right here looks a lot more like a gamma function, except we have this denominator part right here. But that's not much of a problem because this thing right here is just a constant in terms of t. So if we chuck this part out to the outside, let's divide it over here, so k plus 1 to the s power. This part right here, this integral, that's exactly gamma of s. So we have our s minus 1 in this exponent right here, so that means this integral evaluates to gamma of s. So all of this stuff evaluates to the sum running from k equals 0 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 to the s times gamma of s. And let's actually shift the index of the sum a little bit. If we take k plus 1 and we turn it into some new k, then that means this k plus 1 right here will turn into a k. And in terms of our bounds right here, if we plug 0 into this old k right here, we're going to have a 0 plus 1, which is 1. So our new k will start from 1, so k equals to 1 to infinity. And for our k in this exponent right here, if we subtract 1 on both sides, then our k will turn into k minus 1. So we're going to have negative 1 to the k minus 1 over k to the s times gamma of s. And this very sum right here, that is exactly the Dirichlet eta function. So this thing right here, that's exactly eta of s times gamma of s. So overall, what did we find? We found that our integral from the very start evaluates to eta times gamma. So we have shown this result right here, and in order to obtain our integral representation for the eta function, we can divide both sides by gamma, assuming that our gamma is never zero. So we're going to have eta of s being equal to 1 over gamma of s times the integral from 0 to infinity of x to the s minus 1 over e to the x plus 1 dx. And there we go. That is one of the integral representations for our Dirichlet eta function right here, which is really quite nice. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see everyone next time.